Hello and welcome to Vatican Media's coverage of the Angelus live today from St. Peter's Square. It's a gorgeous sunny day here in the Vatican. A very foggy start to our New Year's here in Rome, but the sun has broken through and so many people have gathered in the square. We see many holding signs from various countries all over the world who have been here. We see details of the Vatican Christmas tree, which comes from the north of Italy, which has graced this square since December 10th, since being inaugurated. We also have the nativity scene, which is a gift from the country of Peru to the Vatican this year, reflecting the peoples and the flora and the fauna and the great traditions of that country. That will remain in place until the feast of the baptism of the Lord on January 9th. So just a few more days to admire that. We see everyone at St. Peter's Square respecting the social distancing norms, wearing masks for the COVID virus, which is still with us in the new year, but hopefully it's a year full of hope and healing and change for all of us with some good news. The Holy Father's window there in the Apostolic Palace, we see his coat of arms hanging from the window on the drape there. The Pope Francis celebrated Mass this morning for the solemnity of the Feast of the Mother of God and this World Day of Peace. In his homily, the Holy Father held up the figure of the Virgin Mary on this, her feast day, and the role of mothers and the great role that women and mothers have in the world and how they make the world a better place. The Pope said, "We need mothers, women who look at the world not to exploit it, but so that it can have life." He said, "Women who sing with the heart can combine the dreams and aspirations with concrete reality." The Holy Father also making a call for greater protection for women, saying, "Let us make greater efforts to promote mothers and protect women. How much violence is directed against women?" The Holy Father said, "Enough. To hurt a woman is to insult God." We see the thousands who have gathered here in St. Peter's Square, and we see them going down a little bit, the Via della Conciliazione, that big street that leads right up to St. Peter's Square. If you're following this on television, we see some of the details of the Peruvian creche, the manger scene, beautifully decorated. It's really something to behold, the wonderful colors and representing the great traditions of the country, and the very tall Christmas tree, which again reminds us that we are very much in the Christmas season still, in this octave. As we said, this is the feast day of the Great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy. Holy Father will come to the window here for the Angelus just about a minute's time. We will hear his message for this Angelus for the very first day at 2022. We wish you all a very happy new year, of course, as we wait for the Holy Father's arrival. And we thank all of you joining us today from wherever you're joining us. We'd like to give you a special welcome and thank you for being with us. We remind you to consult our website for all the latest on today's celebrations. The curtain being drawn back now, and we see Pope Francis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters,
buon anno.
Hello, and happy New Year.
Iniziamo il nuovo anno affidandolo a Maria, madre di Dio.
Let us begin the new year entrusting it to Mary, the Mother of God. The Gospel of today's liturgy speaks of her, taking us back once again to the wonder of the crib. The shepherds hasten towards the stable, and what do they find? The text says they find Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. Let us pause on this scene and let us imagine Mary, who, like a tender and caring mama, has just laid Jesus in the manger. We can see a gift given to us in that act of laying him down. The Madonna does not keep her son to herself. She doesn't just hold him in her arms, but she hands him, she shows him for us to admire and adore. She presents him to us. She not only holds him in her arms, but puts him down to invite us to look at him. Behold Mary's maternity. She offers the Son who was born to all of us. And in laying him before our eyes and without saying a word, she gives us a wonderful message. God is near, within our reach. He does not come with the power of someone who wants to be feared, but with the frailness of someone who asks to be loved. He does not judge us from his throne on high, but looks at us from below like a brother, rather like a son. He is born little and in need, so that no one would ever again be ashamed. It is precisely when we experience our weakness and frailness that we can feel God even nearer, because he appeared to us in this way, weak and frail. He is the God-child who was born so as not to exclude anyone. He did this to make us all brothers and sisters. And so the new year begins with God, who in the arms of his mother and lying in a manger, gives us courage with tenderness. We need this encouragement. We are still living in uncertain times due to the pandemic. Many are frightened about the future and burdened by social problems, by personal problems, dangers stemming from the ecological crisis, injustices, and by global economic imbalances. Looking at Mary with her son in her arms, I think of young mothers with their children fleeing wars and famine, or waiting in refugee camps. There are many. And contemplating Mary, who lays Jesus in the manger, making him available to everyone, let us remember that the world can change and everyone's life can improve only if we make ourselves available to others, without expecting them to begin. If we become craftsmen of fraternity, we will be able to mend the threads of a world torn apart by war and violence. Today, we celebrate the World Day of Peace. Peace is both a gift from on high and the fruit of a shared commitment. Gift from on high, we need to implore it of Jesus because we are not capable of preserving it. We can truly build peace only if we have peace in our hearts, only if we receive it from the Prince of Peace. But peace is also our commitment. It asks us to take the first step. It demands concrete actions. It is built by being attentive to the least, by promoting justice, with courage to forgive, thus extinguishing the fire of hatred. And it needs a positive outlook as well, one that always sees in the church, as well as in society, not the evil that divides us, but the good that unites us. Getting depressed or complaining is useless. We need to roll up our sleeves to build peace. At the beginning of this year, may the Mother of God, the Queen of Peace, obtain harmony in our hearts in the entire world. Holy Father now invites us to pray the Angelus with him.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut digni officiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo nunciante, Christi Fili Tui, incarnazione coniovim, per passionem eius ad crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucia Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Exop nunque tusque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen.
Holy Father's blessing over this square and to all of us who are following along through the means of social communications or on social media.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, the Pope continues, at the beginning of this new year, I wish all peace. This is the compendium of every good, peace.
Ricambio di cuore e con gratitudine.
I exchange with gratitude with the President of the Italian Republic, Sergio Mattarella, and I assure him of his prayers and the Italian people. Today is the World Day of Peace, which began by Paul VI. In 1968. In this year's message, I was saying peace is made through dialogue and education of the generations. Without these things, the foundations for peace. I thank you for all the initiatives that have been started for this day, in particular, because of the situation that the pandemic has created. In Savona, last night, the vigil, I'd like to thank them for that initiative. And all those, and I'd like to greet all the participants organized by Sant'Egidio, peace throughout all the earth. We see all the participants there. And throughout the world. Those of Sant'Egidio are great, they're good, doing a good job. In collaboration with the diocese and various parishes, thank you for your presence and your efforts. And I greet all of you, dear Romans, pilgrims. I greet all the young people from Curatone and all the families and the faithful from Padua. And from Comunuovo, from Sotto il Monte, from St. John the 23rd, the Pope who wrote the encyclical Pacem in Terris, which is ever more relevant. Peace, peace, peace. We need peace. I was watching the images on a program A Sua Immagine, about war, about the displaced, about sufferings, the things that are happening in today's world. We want peace. Best wishes to all of you. Don't forget to pray for me. Happy New Year. Have a great lunch and arrivederci. Until tomorrow. Bravi. Pope Francis greeting the crowds here, wishing them a happy new year, and underlying the great need for peace. He said that on this 55th World Day of Peace, he pointed to three paths for building lasting peace. He said dialogue between generations, education, and work. When these are missing, we're missing the foundations, he said, for true and lasting peace. He greeted all of those present and all of you following along from home or from wherever you're joining us today. Again, on behalf of all of us here at Vatican Media and Vatican News, we wish you all a very happy and blessed new year. Laudetur Jesus Christus.